The media browser is a section that allows me to find, preview, access, convert, and upload media that is already on my hard drive and external drives. At the top of the media browser, I have three tabs: Explore, Scan, and Recent Files. And these are just ways that allow me to access my media quickly and easily. In the Explore tab, I can simply browse through my folders to find the content I want to use. So now I'll go through and open up my public folder and select the trackback folder, which contains loops and beats I'd like to use. You can find these loops and beats on trakax.com. By opening up one of the folders, I can see my audio. By clicking on the file once, I can preview it. I can stop the preview by pressing stop. If I want to preview a longer file, I can again search through the Explore folders and find a long file that I want to use. I can click on it, and I can use the play position pad to scroll through it. Again, I can press stop. If I'd like to preview some video files, again, I can browse through my folders and find the video I'm looking for. Again, I can click on it to preview it. You will notice the preview will be shown in the video output screen. Again, I can use the play position pad to scroll through it and press stop to end the preview. However, I'd like to draw your attention to the video output screen for a second. When previewing or watching a video in the media browser, you can use the play controls within the video output screen. The media browser is previewing the videos in the quality they were created in, which means the media browser can now be used as a media player for all your content. If I preview a piece of video and press stop, the video is only paused until you press play again. You can also use the video output play position pad to scroll through the video. I can also output the media I am previewing to a second monitor if one is attached. And I can also preview the content in full screen.
Oh, lovely, show me the medal. Wow, show me the medal.
Again, in the media browser, I can also find and preview photos by clicking on them. So let's go back to the trackback bundle that I opened earlier. I can now begin to use these loops to create a mix by simply dragging and dropping the file into the mixing screen. To build up my mix, I can drag and drop more loops in. If I'd like to bring a file into the Trakkutter to edit, simply double click on it or drag it onto an available tab. As you can see, I now have multiple files in the Trakkutter ready to edit. This works the same for video. I can simply drag a video into the mixing screen to add to my mix. Or again, if I want to edit the video file, I can simply double click on it. By right clicking on a file in the media browser, I can bring up a number of options. You can copy a file and paste it into the mixing screen or another location on your PC. You can play the file. A new feature we've added is the ability to play the file in its default player. For example, if I right click on an MP4 file and select play in the default player, the file will now play in QuickTime, as that is my default player for MP4s. If I play a photo in the default player, it will default to Picasa, as this is my default player for photos. This is a nice feature if you wish to preview files in your default player instead of the video output screen. There's also the option of viewing the file in Windows Explorer. This is a very nice feature if you have a lot of media files in a folder and would like to see them in a thumbnail format. We've added the ability to drag these files directly from Windows Explorer into the mixing screen or Trakkutter. We've also given you the ability to upload a video directly to YouTube from the media browser. The quality of the upload is dependent on the quality the video was created in. We've also added the ability to convert an audio or video file to a new file format. This is a great function if you wish to convert a file quickly so it can play on different devices such as an iPhone, iPads or PSPs. To learn more about converting files from the media browser, please see the Converting from Media Browser video. You can also delete the file from your hard drive and check the properties of the file, which shows you some useful information like the size of the file, last modified, and the video and audio properties. If I click in the Scan tab, I can search through specific folders to find various file types. Firstly, I'm going to click on the Browse folder icon to find the folder I want to search. Here I will select my documents to scan, click OK, and then I can click on the audio icon to search for my audio content within this folder. In the right hand corner, I can see the amount of audio files that have been found. I can click on the video icon to search for my video files within this folder. And I can also search for photos by clicking on the photo icon. Again, I can preview the files here and drag and drop them into the mixing window, or double click on them to place them in the Trakkutter. For Vista users, you can also use the search function on the Windows button to find your media content. You can also drag and drop them into the mixing screen. The Recent Files tab is a handy tool to access all the media you've previously used in your mixes. You can clear individual or all files by right-clicking within the window and selecting Remove from List or Remove All. If you're in the mixing screen and are using a file that you'd like to find in the media browser, right-click on the file and select View File in Browser. The complete file will now be highlighted in the browser, ready to be used or edited. The media browser also has an Options button. You can click on this to see the media scan options. You can turn these options off by clicking on the box. The first one is automatically play a media file when it is selected. This is just previewing a file when clicked on once. Then we have monitor the local computer for new media files. trakAxPC will find new files when created and shows them to you automatically in the media browser.